Hi, good to see you guys. I just got back from tour. I was on tour with Noel for 6 weeks, and not only was it a comedy tour, but for me it was also a tour of America's unhealthiest foods. Turns out every city in America has their own special way of fucking up your arteries, and I had to try it. I had to try every single one. Philly cheesesteaks, Whataburger, Po' Boys, deep dish pizza, you name it. If it gives you heart disease, I ate it. I don't think I had a single vegetable in 6 weeks. And as a result, I've packed on a few extra LBs. I'm trying to find the motivation to hit the gym again, and I thought now would be the perfect opportunity to talk about some fitness content. There's no shortage of fitness content on the gram. If you want to watch someone climb a rope, or do chin-ups, or hammer a tire, I guess, that's only a few taps away. But maybe you watch these videos and you think,
Something's missing.
sure. It's really, really, really cool to watch someone pick something up and put it back down, but I don't know, I watch these and there's an itch that's not being scratched. And that itch is on my funny bone. That's right, comedy. That's what these are missing. Well, as it turns out, after browsing fitness pages for hours and hours, I've realized something. Not only is there a plethora of fitness comedy videos on Instagram, but I've also realized that there is a correlation between being jacked as shit and being fucking hilarious. It's an inverse correlation. The more jacked you are, the less funny you are, but the more you think you should try and be funny, and the more you think the world needs fitness comedy videos. Does that make sense? Maybe because, I don't know, because when you laugh, your abs get better or something. I don't know. Just because you get really good at something doesn't mean that the next step is comedy. I could be wrong. That is where really good parody comes from. So maybe I'm wrong and we should check some of this stuff out. Okay, so first off, we have this dude, Scott Matheson. He's an actor and he believes in being the best that you can be. No surprise there. And he's jacked as fucking balls, dude. Look at that. Look at these veins, dude. How do you even get veins down there? How is it possible to be in such good shape that you can see the veins that lead down to your dick? I think the medical term is boner veins. You can see his boner veins. How is an 8-pack not enough? You know, he looks down one day, he's got 8 abs. That's 8 more than the average person. And he's like, no, it's not, you can't see my boner veins yet. Anyways, most of his videos are like normal fitness shit. You know, here's a video of him lifting something up and putting it back down and then jumping over another thing and then lifting another thing up and rinse and repeat. The people that follow him like it. Hashtag goals, great content as usual. Beast, getting the job done. Swole, so strong. See, standard fitness shit, right? But then he posts this. Okay, so this is pretty clearly one of the worst videos that has ever been made on Earth. I think I'd rather watch Two Girls, One Cup over watching that again. Oh, you know what's a funny problem that I have? Is that I'm too fucking jacked. That's a hot take on fitness. What happens when you're too jacked? Nobody's talking about this. Like when you try to use your flip phone in 2019 and you're too fucking jacked and it breaks in half in your hand. These
These
are
are
real
real
issues.
issues.
I now see what he's talking about when he said he was an actor. That was quality shit right there. Like, what noise was that he made when he ripped out of his shirt? Did he come? Actually, honestly, he probably did. That would not be out of character. When you fucking bust a nut because you're too fucking jacked and you bust out of your shirt and it turns you on so much that you bust a fat fucking nut. Okay, so that might seem like the worst sketch of all time, but you know what? He actually outdid himself. Barstool reposted his video and said, the caption said, "Send this guy to Mars and never come back," or something like that. And this was his response.
Send this guy in a rocket ship to Mars and let him never come back? Mars?
Mars is
is so lit!
Mars is lit. Mars is lit! Elon Musk just rolled over in his grave. He's not even dead. That phrase is so bad, it killed Elon Musk just so he could roll over in his grave. They were like, send him to Mars. So his response was like, let's make a sketch where I actually go to Mars. That's so fucking dumb. It's like kind of genius in how dumb it is. It's amazing how unlikable you are. It's so true. It's like, it's kind of backwards. It's like, I don't think you would be this jacked if you didn't care what people thought about you, right? So then why go and make yourself like the worst person ever? Anyways, it can't get worse than that, right? Right? Well, if I know Scott, it probably will. Let's take this Valentine's Day sketch he made. It's called How to Get a Gym Girl on Valentine's Day. I can't eat those chocolates because of my washboard abs, you fucking loser. Do you even know who I am? I'm a gym girl, okay? I'm so ripped, I don't have to use words. I can just point to my shit, and you should know what I'm talking about. Dude, imagine getting 4 Tupperwares filled with grilled chicken and beans for Valentine's Day, and then being stoked. Holy shit, life must just suck so much at that point. Why is he miming everything? It's so weird, like the background music is so quiet that you can still hear everything else that's going on. They could have just used their voices too. Or maybe that's the real comedy in this video. Maybe this is like, you know, when you're a jacked mute. Maybe that's the meme. I don't know. All right, this part got copyright claim, so I'm just gonna dub it over. Oh my God, workout bands. Cool, thank you. Yeah. Oh my God, let's drink wine. Psych, it's a protein shake. What could it be? Oh, new workout gear. Cool, thanks. What would that be like just to not enjoy anything in life except for fitness? No diamond ring for me, please. Fitness gear, that's what I want. You think she's gonna have Lululemon make her wedding dress? Their wedding cake is like gluten-free zucchini bread or something? Cash bar, for sure. Cash juice bar. No alcohol. God, being friends with them would suck ass. Oh, fuck. I'm just realizing now that that is the gym that I go to. Cool. Good. Nice work, Cody. Poke fun at some people who are definitely going to see you in the near future and who are also willing and able to beat the shit out of you, probably. Good. Maybe I'll just show up with some Tupperwares filled with chicken and veggies as like a peace offering. All right, this one's Thanksgiving themed. It's called When It's Your First Time Trying to Cook Turkey and Gains Our Life. I just love that he risked third degree burns all over his stomach, grease burns, in order to get this shot of the turkey on fire and his washboard abs in the background. Unbelievably dedicated to the fitness comedy cause. He's trying to make us laugh to ease our pain, but also motivate us to hit those gains. That's what fitness comedy is all about. I like the caption to this one because it perfectly sums up all of these videos. When you insert normal day-to-day thing, but gains are life. Just fill in the blank and you have yourself a fitness comedy sketch. When you're mowing the lawn, but gains are life. And the lawnmower has a bunch of like, you know, weights on it or something. There you go. Or maybe, you know, when you go to have sex with someone, but gains are life. And, you know, you're engaging in sexual contact with another consenting adult, but you look at yourself in the mirror and you bust a fat fucking nut. Because you turn yourself on so much because you're fucking hot, dude. You're jacked as shit and gains are life and you hit those gains and you're jacked as shit. Look at those fucking abs and you bust a fat fucking nut. And then she's like, oh, but you don't care because you're hot. There's another one for you, Scott. See, these videos that we've watched so far are bad, obviously, but it's not truly awful Instagram comedy without the top text and the bottom text. And luckily, I came across this video right here. When your gym partner takes a rest day, by Jeff underscore fitness. Fuck it. You know what? I'm renaming my Instagram account to Cody underscore YouTube. Cody underscore mega bad boy sex icon comedy YouTube. Haha.
Yo, spa. I can't make it up. Spa.
This part got claimed too, so I'm just gonna sing it for you guys. I'm lonely, I'm so lonely. There's nobody to call my own. I'm so lonely. Oh, it's cause his gym partner is gone. And he's lonely. This is another theme with these videos and like Instagram comedy in general. It's like they have a joke and but they just do the joke 10 times in a row. And it's like, come on, this could have been a Vine, dude. They treat comedy like a workout. They load up the joke and then they rep it out 10 times. It's like, no, treat it like a max set. Load up as much as you can of the joke and then rep it out one time.
What's up, Jeff?
Oh, what's up, bro?
All right, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and guess that he calls him skinny. I don't know, you know, it's just a hunch. Let's find out.
What's going on?
Long time no see.
How you been?
Everything's good out here. Grinding.
What happened to you?
What you mean?
You're so skinny.
Are you for real?
You're so skinny.
What the fuck you mean, bro?
Dude, who in the right mind would look at this dude and say that he's getting skinny? Who? This guy is huge. His tricep is bigger than my whole sep. He's a fucking beast. You gotta be on acid to think this guy's skinny. Yo, bro, you're so skinny. Why are you getting so skinny? Also, why are you a centaur? I'm freaking out right now. Where are we? These guys did do like a semi-funny song about breaking up with your gym partner. Here, I'll play it for you.
Hello?
My workouts ain't the same no more. Since you left me, I've been all alone. When I'm benching, I'm so scared now. When I look up, no one's there now. My heart is the only thing.
You
and me just weren't meant to be.
I just want to call these guys and be like, there's other things in life. It's not just lifting. Lifting is a thing, and you can do it, and that's awesome. Go better yourself, you know, feel good, whatever. But it's not the only thing. Like they sat down and they were like, let's make a whole song. I bet you the question, what should it be about, was never asked. It was just, you know, mutually understood without even speaking that this would be about the gym. Cause that's the only thing. No, there are other things, you know? Kite surfing, there you go. All right, this last video that we're gonna watch, it's called Dress to Impress. Alright, I think that's probably where we're gonna start winding this video down. As you can see, my graph has held up nicely. The more jacked you get, the less funny you get, but the more you think the world needs fitness humor, and the more you forget that other things in life exist. But you guys, as I said, you know, I'm trying to find the motivation to get back in the gym myself, so it was nice that we could talk about fitness for a little bit. And you know, maybe in the future, we'll talk again about fitness. Fitness dick in your mouth. Whoo! There it is. There it is, folks. That's the only funny fitness joke. Right there. That's the one. Oh, man. That felt good to say that. Fitness. Fitness fucking merch plug in the video. Guys, I have a brand new merch website. That's right. A dedicated website. ShopCodyCo.com. How vain is that shit? And there's brand new merch up there. We got this beautiful pink shirt on this guy that looks like mine and Noah Centineo's love child. We got this cool as hell blue shirt. These dope ass joggers for you to do fitness in. If you're looking for fitness gear with my name on it, there you go. If you want to support the channel, guys, then pick something up. I appreciate it. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.